Just let me hear some of that rock and roll music. Any old way you choose it. It's got a backbeat, you can't lose it. Any old time you use it. It's gotta be rock and roll music.
Okay, so this is the first thing of the Rocky and the Roll Blues.
Rocky and Roll's only cruise. This is the first night, guys. We're having a great time. We're at Studio B right now. The Sounds of Time are playing. Me and Dave are just kicking back with everybody here. So have fun, okay?
And we'll
see you later.
Song, are you ready? Goodness gracious. Boom, boom, stood still.
Way down south, they gave a Jew.
Hey, Rocky and the Rollers, I'm Alan Brady. Well, years ago, they used to call me Al Brady, and you might remember at Little Darlin's Rock and Roll Palace, probably the biggest and best, most fun nightclub that was in the history of rock and roll back in Kissimmee, Florida. I was the house disc jockey, and I worked with Wolfman Jack all those years. And here on the cruise, well, let me tell you, we're cruising, we're having a great time, and this afternoon we're having a great trivia show with mystery artists. That's what I do best.
Sean, that's him singing Maybe. Claim to fame was in 1971, he would actually go on to record another great song that we have become so familiar with. And that song was this, a produced song by the guys you're going to be seeing right here on the cruise, and that is Jay Siegel and the Tokens. This is Robert John's version, which actually had a little dog bark, which the Tokens didn't have.
Gotta be rock and roll music.
done with the prom night. Everybody had a great time, and I'm tired. I'm fixing to go upstairs and have a drink with everybody, you know what I mean? So be here next year, or be square, all right? Come on, we're going to the prom. Let's go.
I have no kick against modern jazz, unless they try to play it too darn fast.
This is the single most important thing you got to learn correctly today. And you should be able to do this without thinking.
Hear my man a wailing sax. I must admit they have a rocking band. Man, they were blowing like a hurricane.
Niagara after all. From the disc jockeys in Boston, around Massachusetts, I was doing Reckon Hoff, so we get some Massachusetts people here. You do? Wow. I hope you're all Red Sox fans. Look at that, the Red Sox Nation is here. Wait, this is the Yankee people over here. He likes the Mets. That's the Mets. Anyway, the disc jockeys in Boston were giving me a little nicknames. Like when I first started at Tallahassee Lassie, you know, in 59, they were calling me Freddie Cannon shot from Guns, Peter Gunn's daddy, Freddie Cannon, and then Freddie Boom Boom, and that's the one that stuck. So it just stayed with me all this time. But I don't mind that. It actually is very good at identifying with me, you know. So thank you.
You know that he's had a lot of production in the past. My question to you is the name Don. Tony Orlando and Don. I've been asked 100 million times how that name came about.
That's a long story. You want to hear it? Okay. Okay. Well, we had a few records as the Tokens hit records, so we started a production company. Like I said at the show last night, we produced records for a lot of people. So we produced a record. We got a track and a song called Candida. So we went into the studio and we had no group at the time. We had the track, which was a music track, and myself. And the writer of the song, whose name was Tony Wine, and another girl named Robin Grion, we were the background singers for the Candida and Knock Three Times in that whole first album. So the guy who was the lead singer on that record, his name was Frank Paris. So we thought it was a great record. We brought the record to Bell Records at the time, and the president of the company loved the record. But he really didn't like the way the lead singer sounded. He says, I love the record, but I think you've got to try to find another lead singer. So Tony Orlando at the time, after he had Bless You and Halfway to Paradise, you all remember those records, he retired from the business of recording, and he became a record executive at a publishing company for CBS Music. So we thought his voice would be terrific to put on this track. So we called him at work one day and we said, you want to come over, you know, come over on your lunch hour and learn this song and put your voice on this track. We think it would be a great song for you. And he said, no, he doesn't want to do this anymore. He said, no, he did. I don't, you know, I'm a professional manager of April Blackwood Music. I really, I don't want to, you know, I'm not a performer anymore. I don't want to lose my job. We begged him, just come over, you'll put your voice on the track and forget about it. So he came over, he learned the song, and he put his voice on, you know, for the lead vocal. We brought it to the record company, they loved the record, and the record came out, and we saw that it was starting to become a big hit. And he said, you can't put my name on that record, I'll lose my job. You know, they don't want me to moonlight as, you know, as Tony Orlando. So I said, okay, so we got a hit record happening. What are we gonna call the, you know, what are we gonna call the artist on this record? We can't call it Tony Orlando. So I came up with this idea. I have three kids. One of my kids, my first daughter, her middle name is Dawn. So I said, how about Dawn? That really sounds nice, and I think that could look nice on graphics, on an album or whatever. And we told Larry Utell, who's the president of Bell Records, we're gonna call this group Dawn. And that's how the group was named.
Yo!
You were part of a very popular group, Sean and I.
True.
What are the rest of the guys doing? We know what you're doing.
Right, I'm still doing this. And I'm really, now three guys are still doing Sha-na-na. They continued the name the entire time and never stopped. And that's Jocko, Screamin' Scott, and Donnie. So Jocko was the drummer, Screamin' Scott was the piano player who played on his sleeves, and Donnie was a guy that no one ever knew was there to begin with, frankly, and he's still there. But he's the guy in the striped shirt who combed his hair all the time, if that rings a bell. The other guys, it's kind of interesting what's gone on. They've scattered around, and a lot of them got out of show business. So to me, the funniest one is Santini, who was the tall guy in the Golda Meir suit. He's an orthopedic surgeon.
It's gotta be rock and roll music if you wanna dance with me.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jay Siegel, the lead singer of the Tokens, and we're here on Rocky and the Rollers Rock and Roll Oldies Cruise. This is the best cruise that we've ever done. We're going to have a great time tonight, and I know everybody out there is going to enjoy it. And we're just happy to be here and make everybody have
fun. Hi, my name is Eddie Rosanico. I'm here with the Tokens, Rocking the Roll Show. And I think one of the amazing times, one of the best times I've had on a cruise, and I've done a few of them. It's a beautiful cruise, beautiful people, having a great time, the food is great, what else can you
ask? Hello everybody, this is Anthony Moore from Bowser and the Stingrays, and I'm here with Rocky and the Rollers and the Oldies Cruise. We're having so much fun here. We're rocking through the ages with everybody from the Villages and everybody else who wants to be here. Why aren't you here yet? You need to come on out with us and have a lot of fun. We got a lot of fantastic artists that we're always going to be having on stage with us, and we can't wait to see you. So come on out, buy your tickets, buy them fast because they go fast, and we'll see you here in the Caribbean.
Hi, Benny. It's Freddie Boom Boom Cannon here. Yeah, we're going to have a good time tonight. We're at the on the Liberty, and we're on this beautiful cruise for the Villages, and we're going to have a wonderful sock hop tonight, and we're going to rock and roll and do everything. And believe me, everybody's going to love it, and we'll have a great time, especially because we got Rocky and the Rollers.
This here is Bowser, and I'm on Rocky and the Rollers Oldies Cruise. I've been on the Rocky and the Rollers Oldies Cruise for the last 2 or 3 years, and I'm going to be on it again next year. So I'm hoping yous join me on the Rocky and the Rollers Oldies Cruise and Grease for Peace.
So keep rocking that piano, so I can hear some of that rock and roll music. Any old way you choose it, it's got a backbeat.
There's been a lot that we've really enjoyed. We enjoyed the dancing, and I think the very best was the Jay Siegel concert. We really, really enjoyed that.
Hi guys, the Villages Twirlers on board with Rocky and the Rollers, Rocking the Caribbean 3. We're having a blast, right girls?
Yeah!
Hello, I'm Connie Casely from the Villages, Village of Bonnybrook, and I've enjoyed all the music from Rocky and the Rollers and Jay Siegel. It's been the greatest part of the trip.
Hi, we're Bill and Sandy Vincent from the Villages. And we're with Rocky and the Rollers at sea on Royal Caribbean, and we're having a wonderful time. We've enjoyed the concerts, but I think our favorite part are the various dances that we have. It's just be a dancing fool and have a great time.
Hi, my name's Pam. This is Bill. We are from Austin, Texas. We're here on the Rocky and the Rollers cruise having a complete blast.
It is a blast, and the best part so far was the concert last night.
Concert with the Tokens and Rocky and the Rollers. This just has been a great, great, fun experience, and we will do it again.
Hi there, I'm Dick Milano. I'm former owner and president of Little Darlin's Rock and Roll Palace in Kissimmee, Florida. I'm here enjoying Rocky and the Rollers. I don't know how many years they've been doing the cruise, but they're fantastic. And probably the best thing about it is watching all these folks from the Villages and the other groups that participated out on that dance floor the other night when Rocky was jamming. Fantastic. Token show last night, fantastic. Looking forward to the Bowser tonight. And Freddie Boom Boom Cannon tomorrow, and ready for next year to come back and do it all over again. Have fun, guys.
I'm Bill.
And I'm Marcia.
We're from Ocala, Florida, and this is our third Rockies cruise, and we loved it so far.
So far, we've had a great time, but our very favorite
They won't stop
part,
dancing.
That's right.
They won't stop dancing.
We love Rocky. So our favorite part is coming up at the sock hop, which is in another night. Can't look forward. Great to put our poodle skirt on and dance the night away.
I'm not putting the poodle skirt on.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Barbara Stone, and I work at Villages, and we're on the Rock and Rollers Oldies Cruise, January 2009. One of my favorite parts is the meet and greet. I think it's really wonderful to get to know people in a different way, in a different manner when they're telling you their own personal stories. Of course, we love the shows too. Oh, and then there's the dances. Looking forward to the sock hop tomorrow. That should be a lot of fun.
The Villages and our favorite part of the cruise so far is Rocky and the Rollers.
And
I'm from the Villages in Florida, and Rocky and the Rollers are our home base group, and we enjoy the music phenomenal for us, and we, that's why we're on the cruise. So,
hey,
thank you.
Sal Brady, and I have just had the most marvelous time here on the Rocky and Rollers Cruise 2009. What a blast from the past. Now, if you've been cruising this year with us, you know it was extremely fun, and the artists were sensational. Yes, Bowser always did his funny stuff. Rocky and the Rollers were backing him up, as well as Freddie Boom Boom Cannon. And the one guy that I really enjoy is Jay Siegel, along with the Tokens, with The Lion Sleeps Tonight. But next year, I'll tell you what, if you're not on that cruise, you're going to miss out. Because next year, it's the Crystals, you know, the Duran Ron and He's a Rebel, and Lightning Lou Christie. They're going to be on the cruise along with, of course, Rocky and the Rollers and myself. And that's from January the 24th through January the 31st, 2010. I hope to see you there, and then we'll rock on.
Backbeat, you can lose it. Any old time you use it. It's gotta be rock and roll music if you wanna dance with me. If you wanna dance with me.